If you've ever used VLOOKUP, I'll bet anything you've run into those nasty NA errors that just mess up your formulas and look downright ugly. Today, that headache ends because I'm going to show you how to get rid of them for good using the if error function. And if you stick around till the end, I'll share a little shortcut that'll save you hours of formula writing. So imagine you're working with this database and you need to figure out how many packages you need to send to each of these zip codes on the right. Using VLOOKUP is straightforward. You open your function. The lookup value is the zip code. The lookup range is your entire database. And by typing 2, you tell Excel to return the number of packages. But when you drag the formula down for the other zip codes, oops, several errors pop up. Why? Simply because those codes aren't in your database since they don't have any packages assigned. A beginner might just send the report off with these errors, but let's not go there. There's a special place in hell for those folks. We'll fix it in no time with the if error function. But before we dive into that, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Every week, I'm giving away a full Excel course valued at $297 to 10 lucky subscribers. All right, back to business. As you might guess, if error is a conditional function that tells Excel what to do if it runs into an error. In our scenario, if there's an error, we want Excel to show no packages registered instead. Here's what you do. Just type if error right before your VLOOKUP formula. After the closing parenthesis of VLOOKUP, add a comma, then tell Excel what to display if it encounters an error. I'll type in no shipments registered in quotes. This instructs Excel to show this message instead of an error. Wrap up the if error function with a parenthesis, hit enter, and you're all set. Now, remember I mentioned a shortcut to speed up your formula creation? Well, instead of dragging your original formula down to apply it to the rows below, most folks don't realize that by simply double-clicking the small square at the bottom right corner of their formula cell, it auto-applies to all the rows. And just like that, dragging formulas is a thing of the past.